Welcome to Demystifying the Dreaded A-B Test. I'm going to make this quick. We might go 10 minutes. We might go 7. We might go 8. Depends how fast I talk. And I need to go upstairs to the pool after this is done. This is not that scary. If you're worried about A-B testing and feature flags, it's nothing to be scared of. Trust me. I will take you on this journey with me. And if you're a CSS developer, you'll love it. Yes. It's not that scary. Trust me. Believe me. It's not that scary. We're going to have fun. This is me. My name's Chris. I'm Salton Burnham on Twitter. If you are a Supernatural fan, you will understand that reference. Who's a Supernatural fan in this room? Raise your hand. Luke, come on, you nerd. What about Buffy and Charmed? Buffy Charmed fans? Y'all are tripping. Stranger Things fans. There's the hand. That's what I'm saying. Good. Sweet. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, if you didn't already know. I'm a developer advocate. I work at Split Software. Split Software is a feature management and experimentation platform. So if you want to know more about that, I will be here till tomorrow morning, and I head back home. So if you want to talk about that, we can. Like Gantt, I also have many of the alphabet in different things like MVPs and GDEs. I'm also an international speaker. I love spooky stuff and horror movies, and I am a tattoo collector, if you didn't know that. So if you know about A-B testing and what I'm going to be talking about, but you want to talk about spooky stuff and tattoos and Bigfoot, UFOs, and ghosts, we can have that conversation because we're in NOLA, and it's spooky down here. Good? Good. All right. So what is A-B testing? Has everybody heard the term A-B testing before? Sure. Cool. So what does that mean? This is from Telly and Nassie. And A-B testing, otherwise known as split testing, split software, is the process of testing two different versions of a web page or product feature against the original existing version. So what does that mean? Well, that's what that means. You have version A, and like this is a horrible design. I used to have some design skills. I kind of suck on the design side now. But this is version A, right? You have two inputs for a username and a password. You have a button, and you might have a link to create an account, right? That's your version A. That's what people are already seeing. That's the existing version that's out there to 100% of your users around the world or based on locale, whatever the case may be. This is your version 2, your version B, your split version, right? Just a little change. Just a little change in the UI. No JavaScript here. This is just a CSS change, right? You take that, and this is probably an anti-pattern, but it's still just moving it out, right? That's your A-B test. That's what we're going to have. Well, why do you do that? Why do you do A-B tests? Why do you run experiments? Why is this so important? And there's a handful of different answers, and there's a handful of different reasons. Awesome user experience. It is our job as people that work on the web to ship amazing, accessible user experiences. Like my buddy Homer, I am also an accessibility advocate. I travel all around the world, and my bread and butter is web accessibility. That's what I do. That in CSS, A-B testing, and feature flags. But it is your job to ship amazing, accessible user experiences, because at the end of the day, we are changing people's lives, and we are changing the world with what we're doing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's what we're doing. But a lot of people don't think about that all the time. What do you mean changing people's lives? You might be working for a hospital company and you're building software that's going to save someone's life, right? You might be working in education and you're going to build an app that's going to help a child learn. You are changing people's lives. Amazing, accessible user experiences. Increase revenue, bottom line, that's just the way it is. You're going to have to make money somehow. You got to find a way to make money somehow. Doing this will help increase your revenue at the end of the day. Data correlation for better business decisions. That's going to kind of fall into the revenue and increasing the revenue. You have to correlate that data, find the data, right? And then you get fine-grained control of your code exposure, which I can explain that later. So how do you do that? Well, we set up an experiment, of course. And this guy's setting up an experiment, but this dude's a moron. That's what we call a moron. That is not an experiment, right? Don't do that. Like, let's look at that again. That was kind of funny. I know I'm at like 5 minutes, but this shit's funny. Right, and don't ever touch a 9-volt battery to your tongue. I know y'all did that as kids. I did it, but don't do that either. That's a bad experiment. First things first, you got to gather that data. Get those metrics. Research your company. Research your own company. Research your competitors. See where your users are at. Understand the demographics. How do you do that? Well, this breaks it down to the scientific method. Do we remember the scientific method? Do you remember when it had 5 steps or the new version that has 7 steps? Thank you. That's 7 step. That don't work. We're going to have to science this a little bit, right? Yeah? It might. We might. There's 7, there's 5, there might be 6. I don't even know. you know, ask a question. Math is definitely hard. Math and science, I let the JavaScript do that for me. If I wrote JavaScript, construct a hypothesis, experiment, draw the conclusion. But the only two you really need to worry about when you're setting up an experiment with A/B testing and feature flags, constructing a hypothesis and experimenting. If we ship this new button, our retention will increase by 20%. It might increase by 19%. If it's 19%, then we put it at 19. If it's 25%, we put it at 25. You don't want to go above your target. You want to hit your target. At some point, you want to find your true north, and you're never going to find your true north. So you need to have a target number in mind. You need to construct a hypothesis and move towards getting to that hypothesis by running that experiment. Experiment time. So how do we do that? Well, we have the control, which is the first version, and we have the treatment, which is the second one. The change in the UI that we're shipping to so many people, right? We want so many people to see A, we want so many people to see B. Well, how do we do that? We do that with feature flags. Well, what's a feature flag? A feature flag is just a way to toggle on and off features to a given set of users, a given set of users within your organization, or a given set of users within the locale of the wherever you want to send this out to. 10,000 people in San Francisco, see B. Everybody else is going to see A. So we do that with feature flags. Okay, that's great. So we got to segment these users, right? We got to break them down. 50% get this one, 50% get that one. It's plain as day. You don't have to do a bunch of configuration. If it's not a huge app and you don't have tons of analytics and data behind it, you say, I want 50% to see this. I want the other 50% to see that. We'll see how it performs, and whichever one performs better after the analytics are gathered, that's the one we are going to ship. You're going to flex that UI muscle. You can do this with just CSS in a JavaScript SDK. That is the background I came from. I came back when I used to do A/B testing in a prior environment. We had a tool that was a WYSIWYG tool. It was all CSS based. You didn't have to write any JavaScript. There was no SDKs for front end, back end, mobile. We have all that at Split, but we didn't have that here. It was just all CSS. As a CSS developer, I built a career on that. I know CSS. So there had to be a way to do this just with CSS, and there is. You can use a vanilla JavaScript SDK, and you can tweak the JS just a little bit, but you can write a lot of the CSS to turn off those UI features or to do whatever you want with that CSS. You're going to flex that UI muscle. You're going to be like water, right? I think that's what Bruce Lee says. Homer would know. Be like water. And you can be a CSS dev and use feature flags. This right here is just a little demo I made a long time ago, and it's just refreshing the browser. And every time you refresh, you might get A, you might get B, and it might change, right? It's really cool. And it's this is just CSS that's changing on the fly. I'm not using JavaScript to change this stuff, because you should never use JavaScript to write your CSS. You use CSS. And what I mean is CSS like CSS. And if you know, you know. At the end of the day, A/B testing is not that bad. This is really a happy cry from my buddy Vincent Price. If you love horror and spooky stuff, you love Vincent Price like I do. Go forth and test in production. I'm going to leave you with that today. That's me, Saltenberg. I'm on Twitter. Hopefully you were taking pictures and tweeting and mastodoning and blue skying and all that good stuff. Resources, if you want those, come find me. It's a bit.ly CSS-feature-flags. Thank you very much.